minus X minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Welcome back to Engineered Labs. Call us Victoria's Secret because we're making a model today. Now,
we are very like chemistry and science oriented company here. We sell these periodic table model displays with the element cubes, and we sell periodic table mini displays. Something else that's super cool that we sell is we have history artifacts as well. And one of the artifacts that is one of my personal favorites actually is the Trinitite from the first atomic bomb, as you can see here. So as we talk about this today, you can go ahead and check out our website. We have these on there.
We're gonna share some of our favorite facts with you as we build this diorama. The tower that we're gonna be kind of modeling ours after held Jumbo, which was the container that was gonna hold the bomb if the bomb didn't detonate.
What we have to build this little 3D model here is we have a glue gun with some glue gloves.
Yep.
We have two different kinds of popsicle sticks. And then we have these giant sticks.
Oh.
We have our handy dandy knives.
Oh,
we've got this Dremel with, of course, safety goggles. Let's get crack-a-lackin'. Safety first, always.
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 Exactly 3 feet, wonderful.
We are just marking them in half so that we can cut them in half. So we can have four.
Very careful. Nope.
Woo! Well, there you go.
That's it.
It smells really good.
It smells really good. Well, while we're kind of sanding these down, do you want to give us our first cute little fact about why it's called the Trinity Test?
I can tell you why it's called Trinitite.
Oh, that works as well.
Since the bomb was detonated in New Mexico, it's very deserty out there. So when the bomb went off, the desert sand was swept up into the mushroom cloud of the bomb, and there it was melted down. As it fell, it cooled into this radioactive glass that is now called trinitite. The kind that we have has a slight green tint to it, and it's a little glassy, but it's more like rocks and sand.
Do you know what was called Trinity? Because neither do I, but I used to know.
So the Trinity bomb was named after the site's official code name Trinity, which was named after a poem by John Donne.
The first piece of knowledge that I can give you is that the bomb was detonated on July 16th, 1945, but it was detonated at approximately 5:29 a.m. because that was like peak weather. Something else that was crazy that I found out. First off, Oppenheimer, who kind of was directing this whole thing here, Oppenheimer wouldn't even get close to the bomb. Obviously, as they were like in pre-production and like making it, he was there. The night before, he wouldn't get close to it because he knew that it could detonate at any time.
Okay, real quick.
Please.
Write in the comments if you say Oppenheimer or Oppenheimer, because I just am curious.
They had some security guards, and as they were watching it, this freaking like lightning, like thunderstorm happened. Can you imagine literally standing next to an atomic bomb, knowing that it's gonna detonate in like a few short hours, and then having like lightning striking by a tower? No, you're not. It was detonated in the Alamogordo bombing range in a place called Jornada del Muerto, which translates to Dead Man's Journey, which is just a great title for a place to detonate a bomb.
When the bomb was detonated, it was so hot. It was hotter than the
Miles
sun.
Miles
The bomb, when it first went off, it was actually hotter than the sun, to the point where no light even came off of it. And once it cooled down to around the same temperature as the sun is when you could finally start seeing the light that came off of it. They actually handed out sunscreen to everybody who was watching it to protect them from the ultraviolet rays, which is kind of crazy. They said it was around over a million degrees.
Cute. Try again. Alongside the sand turning to glass, the tower in which the actual bomb itself was detonated from just vaporized. The Trinity test was, I believe, 1.5 times stronger than the bomb that was dropped over Hiroshima.
When the test bomb was detonated, just a random citizen that was 150 miles north of where the bomb was detonated said that it lit up the sky like it was daytime. 150 miles away.
There was a US Navy pilot who was flying near Albuquerque who said that it lit up his cockpit like the sun. And he radioed into the tower and was like,
what was that?
And the tower, all that they said was just don't fly south.
Because keep in mind, this was like one of the most top secret
missions
that was going on in the world. It was like a race to see who could create the first atomic bomb. Mm-hmm. And this was around World War II, and so they were worried about spies and nobody else in the world except for the people who were working at the site. Mm-hmm. Even knew that this was going on.
Yeah, they didn't release what that big flash was to all the bystanders. Give me a minute. No, they didn't tell any of the people that saw the flash. They didn't tell them what the flash was until the bombing of Hiroshima.
By the way, we dropped a nuke
in our home country.
While they were doing the math, there was a very large chance when they first did it that the bomb could set off a chain reaction that would burn up the atmosphere and basically light the whole world on fire. Yeah.
It was Edward Teller, actually, the one that was handing out the sunscreen, that was like,
hey, by the way, this could literally kill the entire world.
But luckily, they found out that there was a decimal point, just a single decimal point that was misplaced. And once that was fixed, then the odds for the atomic bomb actually working and not destroying the world was in a lot higher favor. I've got my end done.
I have two more. I've been talking too much, so.
Almost done. Is it recording?
Did you press record?
No.
That is a little crooked, but I'm sure that's fine. Oh, did we tell you that we're gonna be exploding potassium off of this tower?
Oh yeah, we're not just building the tower, we're gonna simulate the bomb.
Well, roof!
Yes. Oh. This needs to be historically accurate, please. Something that is just wild to me and really is just a...
Oh, that's
attached. Something that just blows my mind. No one knew that this was gonna work. They just kinda did the math, put some decimals in wrong places and said, yup, drop it. Is your husband calling again?
What are we talking about?
It was a huge breakthrough for war and battle and politics. It kind of was the weapon to help end like wars like that.
Yeah, it's just crazy what the human mind is capable of.
I feel like so many of like the issues that create like cause wars are just not understanding other people.
Communication.
And like thinking of like others in other countries and stuff as just like completely different species almost. It's hard to all get along. You know, Robert Oppenheimer, whatever, was really good friends with Einstein.
Okay, here's a question.
Yeah.
If you could go back in time to any historical moment, what would you go to? too.
That's hard. The Roman Empire would be cool to witness.
How often do you think of the Roman Empire?
Or the Renaissance would be cool too. I just think like, yeah, honestly, like going back to like
during the
when
Olympics.
Everyone was like,
there's Greek gods.
What about
that's,
you?
That's crazy, because I was gonna say I want to go back to when your mom was born.
Why?
No, actually, I'd probably, honestly, just to feel the
what?
No, but to feel the emotion of the first landing on the moon. I think like to be in the control room when they're all like celebrating,
that'd be pretty cool.
Would be dope. Which also like is another thing about the bomb. There was obviously the physical shock factor, but the mental shock factor of we did it was a lot more than the physical shock of the shockwave.
I think it really weighed heavy on Dr. like Oppenheimer. You're creating a weapon, you know. It's not like you're a doctor who's like creating something like a medicine or
right. He created something that could end a war.
Yeah. He created something that was meant to kill people. That would be hard to know the whole time that like I'm building this thing that could end millions of lives.
If you could meet Oppenheimer, what would you say to him?
There's a couple things I would ask him. Can I say more than one?
Yes, please do.
I would ask him if he could go back and do it all again, would he?
Ooh.
And I would ask him if he could go back and like do something differently. What would he do differently?
Yeah. I just feel like if I was talking to someone as smart as Oppenheimer or Albert Einstein or really anyone that like worked on something like this or just any scientist, I feel like I would feel so
stupid.
Small. Yeah, so stupid. What bomb do? I just can't even imagine talking to these men who worked on something as complicated as a nuclear fission plutonium big boy bomb.
Mm-hmm.
And just being like, so tell me about yourself. What color is your toothbrush?
What's your favorite color?
What do you have for breakfast?
What would you say or ask him?
Yeah, probably what his favorite food was.
I really just want to know if he, like, knowing everything that he knows now, seeing how everything played out, like, if he would do it again. Like, if he has any regrets or, I don't know. Because he went through a lot afterwards, too. And it's just, like, the emotional toll, especially after hearing about the bomb dropping.
Hang on, my dad's calling. Hola.
Been going combined for
open your mouth.
Almost done, guys. Almost done.
Looking pretty good.
Everyone, this is Luke.
Say hi, Luke.
No,
oh my gosh.
All right, open wide. Good.
Yep. Good.
That'll do it. Well, we'll come back tomorrow to do the explosion.
And we're back.
We did it.
This is all complete. We've got what we need. So let's go ahead and
let's just get to it. Let's keep going. So, you know, it would be really cool if we like actually exploded plutonium, but it also wouldn't really be that cool. So we're gonna explode potassium in water instead.
Okay, so this is kind of what we think. We got our potassium and then crucible cup. String.
Okay. Off to the explosion site.
Okay.
And transition.
Boom. A transition.
Preparing the explosives.
Ew.
No.
Just setting up, we got our extra camera, some extra lenses, my finger in the lens because I don't know how to film. We got our water, our potassium right there, fishing line, some actual weights rather than rocks crappily tied, our knife, and our vessel.
Look at my catch, Ma!
We're almost ready for liftoff.
Okay. Yo, the tower actually stayed.
Yeah.
Pretty intact.
Now, in the real thing, the tower incinerated, so this would be gone. Ready?
Yep.
So pretend that this was incinerated.
There we go. There's a dog behind me, isn't there?
Yep.
No. Hi, happy dog. Wait, where are you going? Come back.
Well, folks.
There you have it. We did it.
So obviously the real atomic bomb was much more...
A little different.
We'd probably, if that was a mini atomic bomb, we'd probably be dead.
Aww.
We're giving away two of our Trinitite displays. These ones are a little different. They have like a picture, so they're actually special edition.
And we are not making any more of them, so they are the only ones to exist. There will be two winners.
Like this video, subscribe to the Engineered Labs channel, and leave a comment down below saying Trinitite. Now we'll enter you for the giveaway.
Yeah.
And that'll be the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching. I can't read my, no, I can't read my.